where we are now, all the way to the last end, it was built for 1,000 people, 1,000 altogether. But they divided the dungeons into five. So this is one. No, this is 200. Five chambers in all, so this is one. So 200 men were here. There was no light. So these three hooks were their only source of light and air for 200 Africans. And they were here 2 weeks to 3 months. So some became blind.
Yes.
Some became blind.
Yes.
You can see the bricks on the floor. It is original at the time. There was nothing like toilet facility. There was no urinal, no mattress to sleep on. So Africans were forced to go to toilet here. They would urinate in addition. And they were in these conditions for 3 months, maximum, minimum 2 weeks. These trenches we are seeing this afternoon were constructed as their urinal. So that when they urinate, it will pass through into the sea. But it got to a time that some Africans could not withstand the suffering here. So they were fighting the white people. The message was freedom, freedom. Those doing that, British identified them and brought them from the other side to this place. So then they created a door addendum. There was a door here before. So they called this site a strong room. So British were not coming to clean the solid waste. So the waste started piling. It started from one level to the other, to the other. Got to a time that the original bricks was buried deep down in the waste. So I want to show you. Therefore, those here, can you move closer to the side? Yes, move to the side. There's something, what I want to show you is on the wall. So if you look, on the wall, you can see this white markings. Let's start from here. So this one, the waist then pipes the bottom of the lines, they reach the high levels. They reach this height. Reach the height line. The bricks was buried. But 1974, University of Ghana, archaeological department, came to do excavation here. Where they found the original brick. It was in 1974. So many died. So died were not buried. They tied stone onto their waist and they threw them to the sea. They eat once in a day, sometimes twice, just to keep them alive. But they left a portion of the waist. No one is here, so let's have a look.
They left some of the boom.
Let's take out the side. All of you look at this place. You cannot see the bricks at this square area. You can see the bricks here. This is waste. See, this is different from the brick. It's waste. So if you were to come here before 1974, this is what you see throughout. That's not the bricks. So then they removed everything. They left this so that generations yet unborn can see. This was tested and it proved that it had toilet, urine, blood, and other. So this waste from our ancestors. When we move to the other side, remember you will not see the bricks, you see some like other dimensions, but that place has not been excavated. That bricks very deep down here. Let's move this way.
Okay, yeah, please, can we maybe have a brief silence and then do some meditation at your own time, wherever you want to start to do your meditation, that is good.
Can I just say one thing? I want to thank our ancestors, for it is their struggle and survival that has allowed us to return. Yes. And I say thank you, ancestors.
Yes.
Yes. If we have not survived, yes.
Yes.
We would yes. not be here.
We would not be here. Right. And they said, the door of no return. But look at it. We have
returned by the thousand. Yes, good thank you.
I was telling.
The father of God.
So that they have like a door to cover it?
No, just onto a left light. Right, this to this.